बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर शगुफ्ता अंदली, प्रोफेसर ऑफ जूलॉजी, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एजुकेशन. आई एम हियर टू टीच यू द कोर्स ऑफ जू जोग्राफी एंड पेलियंटोलॉजी. टुडेज टॉपिक इज एवोल्यूशन ऑफ एलिफेंट. वेरियस क्लेडोग्राम्स हैव बीन documented by different paleontologists at different times based on various evidences. As per this cladogram, it is suggested that Morytherium should be placed in a separate phyletic lineage which emerged during Eocene, and the Paleomastodon is the ancestor to all proboscideans. While some consider Morytherium as ancestor to all proboscideans and it emerged during Paleocene. This is the classification of proboscidea which has recently been presented, and according to this, proboscidea are mainly divided into two groups, Plesioelephantiformes, which is further divided into three families, family Numidotheriidae, family Barytheriidae, and family Dinotheriidae, while Elephantiformes is further divided into three superfamilies, six families, and four subfamilies, and number of genera, which we will study later on during this topic. Here a term incertis sedis is used, which means that these genera have uncertain status regarding their classification. Dear students, you know that evolution is the result of changes in the environment. And these changes in the environment and climate have exerted profound effect on the evolution of elephant. During Paleogene, about 65 to 24 million years ago, the Red Sea did not exist, and Africa and Arabia formed one large continent which was isolated from Europe and Asia by a wide ocean called Tethys. These continents were then situated much more to the south, and moreover, the global climate was much warmer than today. The proboscidea originated in this isolated landmass formed by Africa and Arabia with a tropical climate, and for many millions of years they evolved there in isolation. During this process of evolution, the changes in the climate and environment affect on the teeth structure and function, skull, development of tusks, proboscis, diet, and size of the elephant. Dear students, it is very important to recall the structure and types of teeth in order to study the process of evolution of elephant. Here in figure A, you can see triconodont tooth with three cones. B is tritubercular tooth. In C, vertical section of a bunodont is shown. D is brachydont molar. E is the hypsodont with high crown. And F is showing the lophodont molar. And these lobes or transverse ridges, you know that they emerge by the fusion of crowns, and these lobes have direct relationship with the diet of elephant. These are the diagrammatic sketches showing the evolution of skull and molar teeth in proboscidean evolution, and you can note the gradual development of proboscis and tusks. There was no proboscis in the primitive one, and later on it gradually developed and it became longer In case of tusks, smaller tusks were evolved, which were bent downward. Here also it is bent downward, while in advanced it started curving upward. And you can also notice that it has one curve, while in case of the recent modern one, it has two curves. In case of teeth, the Lophodonti has been induced from primitive to the modern proboscidea. Now we will study the characteristic features of different proboscidea starting from primitive to advanced. Erythrium is an extinct genus of early proboscidea found in Morocco. It lived about 65 to 55 million years ago, and the type species is Erythrium azorzorum. It is the oldest, smallest, and most primitive known elephant relative. It has an estimated body weight of 3 to 8 kg. The lower premolars have one large main cusp, and the uppers have a pair of two large cusps. The molars are bunodont, means the cusps are present only without crests. Phosphatherium lived in Paleocene deposits of Morocco. Its nasal openings were in front of the snout, as in most proboscidean, but it lacked a proboscis. It was about the size of a dog, and it had a weight of 10 to 15 kg, but it was not a dwarf. It did not have a trunk, tusks, nor horizontal displacement of the premolars and molars. It shows a tendency towards more lophodont molars, which means that pair of cusps that are next to each other are fused into a smooth transverse crest or loaf. It was probably a browser that fed on aquatic plants. It is the first genus and something like the direct ancestor not only of all other elephants. Numidotherium is found in early Eocene of North Africa about 50 million years ago. The first upper and third incisors are reduced in the size and the second is large. There are two lower incisors, a large mesial one and a small lateral one. There is an upper canine but no lower one. There are three upper and lower premolars. There is a long diastema. Its skull is short and high, which is an advanced condition. Moritherium has been asserted by some authors to be the earliest known ancestor of the elephant family tree. It is a strange animal with elongated body and short legs. Some have doubts whether it should be included in the proboscidea or not. This animal did not have a nasal cavity with a large opening, suggesting that it did not have a trunk. It has a very small first lower incisor and large second. Now, Moritherium is interpreted to be a form that evolved in a different direction, and that did not give rise to the later proboscideans. Its molars were bunodont and bilophodont, which does not strictly refer to having lobes, but refers to the number of pairs of cusps or lobes. Phiomia is the prehistoric elephant. It was about 10 feet long and half a ton in weight. It lived in woodlands of northern Africa in late Eocene to early Oligocene about 37 to 30 million years ago. It thrived on a diet of terrestrial vegetation and probably evidenced the beginnings of a distinctly elephant-like trunk. Paleomastodon lived in Oligocene of Egypt. In Paleomastodon, a third lobe starts to develop in the first and second molar. The lower tusks were flat for scooping out plants from swampy water. They were 3 to 6 feet tall and about 2 tons in weight. They had a trunk, long lower jaws, and short upper and lower tusks. Changing geography has influenced the evolution of Proboscidea very strongly. During Paleogene and earliest Miocene, Africa was isolated from Europe, Asia, and Indian subcontinent by tethys, and it is thought that there must have been some sporadic faunal exchange, but the fauna which remained there, it remained as an endemic. By a process called plate tectonics, these continents moved north, but the southern ones a little faster than the northern ones. The result is that the tethys became narrower and the Alps and Himalayas started to develop. North of this mountain chain, a large sea developed named Paratethys. As this slow and gradual process continued, the separation between Africa and Eurasia became narrower and shallower. At the same time, global temperatures were fluctuating and overall decreasing, and extensive glaciers started to develop on Antarctica. Since the ultimate source of that ice is water of the oceans, this process caused fluctuations of the levels of the world's oceans. The interaction of tectonics at sea level caused fluctuating terrestrial connections between Africa, India, and Eurasia, resulting in an equal number of events of faunal exchange. Close to 18 million years ago, Gomphotherium and Zygolophodon reached Europe, and Gomphotherium reached also East Asia. Around 16.5 million years ago, there was another faunal exchange, and this time the Proboscidean Dinotherium reached Europe, while Zygolophodon and Coerulophodon may have reached Eastern Asia. Dinotherium lived in Miocene and Pliocene in Europe and Asia. It is often larger than elephant. It is distinguished by a pair of tusks directed downward. You can see the downward directed tusks. It is the only proboscideans which lack upper tusks, but instead they have lower tusks which appear from the mandible in downward direction and then curved backward. You can see they are directed downward and then backward. They are perfectly lophodont. The first molar has three lobes, each with a loaf. But the second molar and third upper molar have only two lobes. And third lower molar has a very small third lobe. It has lost the first two molars. Next is Chilgatherium, which is named after the locality from where it was discovered first. It used to live 27 million years ago. It sometime appears before 18 million years ago on the Indian subcontinent. and around 16.5 million years ago in Europe. It did not disperse and reach northern and eastern Asia. The Chilka fossils derive from the western plateau of Ethiopia. Hemimastodon is known by the two upper molars from Indian subcontinent, which had been assigned to a large pig, but which in fact represent the most primitive elephantoid. Its incisors have morphology different from Phaeomia and older Proboscidea, but similar to that of Elephantoidea, and it suggests that it is about 24 million years old and used to live in the same area in Pakistan deposits of the Dera Bugti beds in late Miocene. Mammutoidea are zygodont, which means that they have molars with transverse crests, each one formed by a pair of principal cusps connected by additional cusps but not by a smooth crest. Like Lophodontia, Zygodontia is believed to be an adaptation to Folivori. The first and second molars and last milk tooth had three lobes, so that is why they are also called as Trilophodont. The last molar had four lobes. Contrary to what happened in the Deinotheres, this group had large upper tusks and initially also large lower tusks, but in the course of evolution, these became very small or even absent. Eozygodon is one of the primitive members of Mammutoidea, which was found in Miocene of Africa with very few representatives. It has recently been reported from Eurasia and suggests an interchange event of Eozygodon from Africa to Asia, which might have occurred at early Miocene. The later forms have better developed zygodonty and reduced lower tusks, but the transition is poorly documented. The zygodont molar suggests that these proboscideans were folivores or at least no grazers. Various geological events resulted in the faunal exchange between Asia and North America. First of all, the opening of Atlantic Ocean separated firstly South America from Africa and during Eocene, North America from Europe. North America was relatively isolated, but it had sporadic contacts with Asia across Beringia. And these connections were in part controlled by sea level. During late Eocene and Oligocene, increasingly colder conditions and the formation of extensive glaciers on Antarctica caused decreasing sea levels, and major faunal exchange occurred between Europe, Asia, and North America, and it is also known as Grand Coupure. Later more, less dramatic faunal exchanges between North America and Asia occurred, and some of them being coincident with Proboscidean datum event and even bringing the first Proboscideans to North America. Gomphotherium used to live 27 million years ago in Africa. This genus dispersed probably around 20 million years ago into Indian subcontinent, around 18 million years ago into Europe, and 16.5 million years ago into Northern and Eastern Asia and North America. In the Old World, it was replaced by Tetralophodon about 11 to 12 million years ago. It has downward-directed upper tusks and flattened lower tusks. It is Trilophodont, and the third molar has more lobes, initially 4 in the lower third molars. Premolars shed after a short use. Next is Coerulophodon. The genus name Coerulophodon derives from the pig-like teeth, which have additional cusps and crenulated enamel. They are Trilophodon, while the third lower molar has 4 lobes. The upper tusks are large, while the lower incisors are reduced. The mandibular symphysis elongated. The oldest is known from the Indian subcontinent, and there is no record from Africa, suggesting the possibility that Coerulophodon may have originated in the Indian subcontinent from Gomphotherium and subsequently dispersed into Africa. Recently from Iran, it has been recovered with the tusks, which are oval to circular in cross-section, lacking enamel band, and strongly curved and double twisted and turns inward at the tip from the late Miocene. This is the sketch of Coerulophodon, and this is the molar tooth, and this is the skull with tusks. This was about the evolution of elephant. I'm sure you have gone through it. Thank you so much.